I'm Bridget Green.
And I'm Cavin Weber.
And today we're bringing up AMD's CES announcements with the one,
the only,
Dr. Lisa Su.
So good to have you here, finally.
I heard you want to talk about technology. You don't have to twist my arm too hard on that topic.
Let's cheers.
Cheers. Are you looking for secrets?
Bring up. Bridget. She's dead. You may not like it, but this is what peak performance looks like.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to The Bring Up.
We are very excited to be here at AMD Space at CES 2023, and Las Vegas luck has shined down upon us because we have the most incredible guest imaginable, Dr. Lisa Su, here with us today.
It's true, Cavin. We'll be deep diving into the announcements from AMD's keynote, and a little bit later on, showing off a pretty nifty system that Cavin whipped up to help us with content creation when we're supporting events like this.
That's right, but we're gonna push that to later because we know that you want to see our number one VIP, so let's get to the interview. Lisa, thank you so much for joining us today.
It's great to be here with you today at CES.
Yeah.
We have been very excited, so I think we're just going to jump right in if you're ready.
All right, let's go.
Okay.
Yeah, let's start with the Ryzen 7040 series, which seems to be doing its part in keeping AMD at the top performance spot, which is fantastic. You mentioned that it has 25 billion transistors, which is a lot, but it's also more than twice the amount of the Ryzen 6000 series. So what do you have to say to all the haters that keep saying that Moore's Law is dead?
Well, first of all, I'm super excited about Ryzen 7040. You know, people saying Moore's Law is dead? No, it's not dead. It's definitely slowing, and you definitely have to, you know, think about how you're using all of this technology and all of these transistors. So we have Zen 4 cores, we have our RDNA 3 graphics, we have a brand new Ryzen AI engine, and it's all how we put it together. And it's not just performance, but also efficiency, you know, very focused on battery life. And so 4-nanometer technology, 25 billion transistors, and we can do a lot with them.
You mentioned Ryzen AI. AI was a really big focus overall for the keynote, I think, but with Ryzen AI specifically going now into consumer products with laptops. And I think sometimes from a consumer perspective, people feel like AI is still a bit of a nebulous concept, right? Like maybe they're one step removed from it, but that's not the case. So can you talk a little bit about why do consumer products need AI capabilities as well?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, AI is really the biggest thing in tech right now, and it's because it touches so many different, you know, things. Now, in consumer devices, let's talk about, you know, where you see AI today. You see AI on your smartphone with, you know, Siri, or in your home with Alexa, or you see it when you surf the internet, when you're doing online shopping, it recommends things that you want. It might recommend things you don't want.
It's very good at that.
But it's also used a lot in, you know, research and development. It's used to help us with medical treatments when you're trying to look at, you know, lots of different cases. And the beauty of AI is the more data you have, the more information you have, the more useful it can be for each one of us. And so, you know, I'm so excited about Ryzen AI because it's the first time we're integrating the AI engine that we developed from the Xilinx technology into our notebook products. And we're going to be able to really take the user experience to a different level in many different ways.
Speaking of that, the big question in the industry for a minute now is when we're going to start integrating the AMD Xilinx IP into Ryzen processors. And it seems like with the advent of AMD XDNA, that's finally coming to fruition. And it's been less than a year since the Xilinx acquisition, and we're already seeing a merge of these two incredible products. So what's next for this dynamic duo?
Well, I'd like to say we were planning it from the start. And, you know, this is the thing. We love the technology that we acquired with the Xilinx team, but we love more what we can do when we put it together with all of our technologies. So think about it. We have CPUs, we have GPUs, we have XDNA, we have AI engines, we have just tremendous IP and capability. Now, we love Ryzen AI. Now, what you can expect is that we're going to put Ryzen AI or that AI engine actually through our entire portfolio. So you're going to see it you know, in client devices, you're going to see it in edge devices. We just also launched the V70 accelerator, which is for the cloud. And then we also talked about, you know, the very, very big thing, MI300, which is also a very, very important technology for AI for the largest applications.
Big thing. Very big thing.
Very technical Lisa. Term. Do you
think?
You like that?
Yeah, I like that.
Do you mean this?
Oh, someone allowed you to bring it on.
Yeah. They did.
I have my ways, Lisa.
I see. I know
some people, Yeah, we wanted to bring a prop for this because this chip is so substantial. It's kind of mind-blowing, and it's like the greatest hits of all of AMD's IP, like you were saying. It's got 3D stacking, it's got chiplets, it's got heterogeneous computing. And so it's just a lot of advancement moving so quickly. Is this like the new normal for AMD?
Can I?
should we let her?
I think we can.
Trust her? Yeah.
Yeah. This really is like all of the power of tech in one place. And think about, chiplets, we've been doing for many, many years, but really, this is chiplets, actually with 3D stacking. So we have 6 nanometer, devices sort of at the bottom. And then we stack on top of it, CPUs and GPUs with 3D stacked chiplets. And then we have high bandwidth memory that's, surrounding it on the side. So it's just an incredible piece of technology. We're very excited about it. And, it's not just the technology itself, but it's like, what are we going to do with it? Yeah. This will allow us to train the largest language models out there. And, there's a lot of excitement around ChatGPT. Have you guys tried it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we may have been playing with it yesterday.
What did you ask it?
We asked it to give us names for the new cyber deck I built, and it had some pretty good suggestions.
So think about that as just the tip of the iceberg. I mean, there's so much more we can do. Actually, what you would want to do is to have, tens of thousands of GPUs training these largest models such that it can become even more helpful for you when you ask, the next question next year.
Don't worry, we saved the very best question for last because it's my favorite question. It's about the AMD Ryzen 7000 X3D series, which is something that me and literally every other human alive has been wildly anticipating for decades now, I think is reasonable to say. During the keynote, I had this problem where I saw so many bests and fastests and world's greatestses that frankly, I just blacked out. So if you could give us a quick recap on this incredible new product, that would be really great for me personally.
The number of people who have asked me for X3D on 7000 series, I mean, everywhere, there has been a lot of anticipation. And, we've been working on this for a long time. So very happy to say that we launched the 7800 X3D, the 7900X3D, as well as the 7950X3D. So we have the full stack, 8, 12, 16 cores. What can you expect? You can expect the world's best gaming processor. We expect 15% on average performance above our 5800X3D. That was the world's fastest gaming processor when we launched it. And I think you'll see that we're able to, depending on what you're trying to do, whether you're trying to do gaming or gaming plus content creation, whether you want more cores or fewer cores, we've got the processor for you.
I'm excited.
It was an incredible keynote. I think it's going to be an incredible 2023. And so what we were thinking was we'll just leave these three chairs here. Mm-hmm. I think they can leave them here for about a year or so, and we'll just put it on your calendar. We'll see you in 2024.
That sounds fantastic. I'm looking forward to a great year and lots of new products.
I know.
Great.
Thanks,
Cavin.
Bridget. Well, that was pretty much what Silicon Dreams are made of, bud.
And speaking of Silicon Dreams, I think it's high time that we introduced my mysterious machination, my abominable abomination, my spectacular...
I think that two's probably good.
Okay, irregardlessly, the bring up is just a small part of what we do here at conferences like CES. Bridget and I and the rest of our team do a lot of work. We do a ton of B-roll, a lot of last minute asks, quick turn edits, and often we're doing that work on spotty hotel Wi-Fi. Yeah. And we've got a reduced travel kit that's not quite as robust as the stuff that we have at our studio back at campus. So, say the line.
Gee, Cavin, I wish that a genius would build a portable PC leveraging the latest AMD technology for us. I think it's time.
To build a cyber deck. All right, Bridget won't let me rant for long, so let's get down to it. Every great project starts with design parameters, so let's get those established now. 1. The whole system needs to fit inside an airplane carry-on, since the whole point is to take it to conventions. 2, it needs a keyboard and monitor of some kind, and it has to be essentially totally self-contained. 3, I'd like to retain the waterproofness of this case as much as possible, which means not drilling holes in it whenever I can avoid it. 4, for specs, I want to use the new Ryzen 7000 series CPU and Radeon 7000 series graphics card to power it. We'll start with a Pelican 1535 Air, which is a nice light case that is exactly proportioned to fit on nearly every airplane carry-on. After doing my preliminary layout in CAD, I start to notice a serious problem. The Radeon 7900 XTX I had just barely didn't fit. It was about 5 millimeters too long to fit between these two fans, and that just wouldn't do. So I sent an email to the engineers and demanded they make a slightly shorter GPU. And thus, the 7900 XT was born. This model is 11 millimeters shorter than the XTX and exactly fit the profile I needed. Thanks, AMD Engineering. After many, many days of design and careful measuring, it's time to get to 3D printing and laser cutting. I have this 6mm black acrylic I'm going to use for the top and bottom panels. Thankfully, I have a friend with a cool laser cutter that can help me cut these out. I'm making a point to glue down as little as possible to avoid making mistakes I can't undo, so instead of gluing down a full micro ATX's worth of surface area onto the bottom here, I made some springy little mounts to give the internals a tiny bit of shock absorption. After quickly designing and printing 3 different iterations for the monitor mount, I found a design I liked enough for now. Someday I'll make this toolless, but today is not that day. Now to drill through this precious case and hopefully not ruin its waterproofness too extensively. I won't be able to safely throw it into the ocean anymore, but hopefully it'll keep the rain off. Now that everything is laid out and power is connected, it's finally time to turn it on. And now is about when I realize I did not design nor build a power button, so that's pretty embarrassing. One small drill hole, a tall momentary button, and a couple wires later, and I have a brand new power button, as if I designed it like that. And voila, it works! And all I have to do is poke some cables out of the way of the fans, because I didn't design in any cable management. All in all, I'm pretty happy with this as a pre-alpha product. I'm looking forward to making changes and adding features as I go, and in the meantime, it's just a pretty cool hobby project and finally something I can scratch off the bucket list.
Cavin, you've been talking about wanting to make a suitcase PC for so long that I actually can't believe that you did do it.
I can't believe you let me. That was like pretty poor judgment on your part.
It probably was. But you did spend a lot of time on it. So maybe we'll do a longer build video about it sometime. And if you're interested in that, please let us know in the comments.
I'm looking forward to that.
We have a little treat for those of you who stuck around to the end of this episode. But first, just want to say thank you so much for watching.
And as always, please be sure to like and subscribe and click that bell icon so you never, ever miss a future episode.
So Cavin, what are we going to call this thing?
I don't know. Why don't we ask? I'm going to ask a robot.
Do you have one?
I've got a robot. Can you give me a list of names for a cool cyber deck? It's yellow.
Oh, you can just say that. It already told you some.
Sure, here are a few suggestions for a cool name for a cyber deck with a Ryzen 7000 series processor and Radeon 7000 series graphic card. Neon Nexus, Cyberstorm, I like that
Cyberstorm
one.
Cyberstorm is
the
good.
Matrix Master, that's Pocket Prodigy.
Pocket Prodigy, I think is it.
The Compact Companion.
That's kind of sweet. You are holding it like it's your best friend that you've ever had.
That's because it's true.